So good morning. We'll start with a new session, software installation and maintenance. Okay. So before going with start installation and maintenance, we'll see some basic stuff. Yeah. On what is software, what is versions, and how we have to upgrade. Yeah. For example, if there's an AX release, like Windows release, Windows 10 got released recently, 1 month back. When Windows 10 got released, well, you know how Microsoft blew the release? First, they will do the beta announcement, and then they will go for a GA announcement. So during this time, they will check with all hardware. They will check with all application. All means what? Not all. Standard hardwares, standard software, standard database. They don't check with all database, all hardwares. So whichever is very widely used, they will check only on that and they will release it to market. Okay? So like which AX also will go through the same phase. They will check with standard IBM hardware, standard IBM applications, IBM databases, Oracle databases. Finally, it gets into market. When it comes to market, you guys are going to use it. So in your company, you may be using a different hardware, different application, different database. If that is the case, then there is something like which will break. Some application won't work, some database won't work. If that happens, what will you do? You will call up IBM or you will call up Microsoft and tell them that, hey, I use Windows 10 and currently this is the problem. Correct? I install Windows 10, but my application is not working. My MS Office is not working. So what they will do, they register a complaint. Yeah, it is called PMR in IBM world. PMR, problem management request. So once that is created, IBM will look into the issue and they'll get it fixed. Okay. So we'll see how to check what version you are currently running. Command is OS level hyphen S. Yeah, it shows some output. You can also get from OS level. Yeah, there are two commands. OS level is the command. It will tell you some number dot some number dot some number dot some number. Okay, so it is nothing but I'll just put it like this. It's 7.1.0.0, right? Or projector? Power is not wrong. Power. Okay. So let's wait, allow it to come. What did the error? No, 1 second, I just switch off the lamp and turn it off. Okay, so this 7.1.0.0 is nothing but, okay, it's come, okay, this is called version, sorry, it's typo, version, release, maintenance, fix pack. You getting it? So this is called VRMF. It's otherwise called VRMF. What is VRMF? Version, release, maintenance level, fix pack. Okay. So what is version? IBM AX 7, IBM AX 6. So this, in IBM world, this number corresponds to full support to the CPU. Okay. In Intel world, we say Pentium 1, Pentium 2, Pentium 3. So in IBM world, it is called power. Power 1, power 2, power 3. So we have power 5, power 6, power 7, power 8. Currently, we are using power 8 processor. Yeah. So we have power 7, power 6. So AX 7 means power 7 support. But this all supports power 8. Also support 6 and 5. But full support for power 7. Okay. So this particular version is the major number. Version. In that, there are some releases, 7.1, 7.2, 7.3, which means full AIX support, full power support, but there are some updates. Whenever there is a new change, new revision, they give point release. It's called minor updates. Okay? Okay, what is maintenance level and fixed pack? Have you heard of service pack in Windows world? Service pack 1, service pack 2. What are they? Okay, so let me get to this. Maintenance level, fixed pack. Okay, now IBM has released AIX 7.1. Now AIX 7.1 is in market. People like us started using it. One or the other will break. You make a call to IBM. IBM will raise a PMR. Okay, now they found that there's an issue with that particular software or particular hardware with that particular OS. They will ask their R&D team to start looking at. Once they find a fix, that is called emergency fix, e-fix. First thing what they do, they create an emergency fix. That fix will be shipped to the requester so that he will put that fix and he will confirm, yeah, problem is resolved. This is called emergency fix or e-fix. Okay. Once the emergency fix is released, another customer having the same issue, he will also raise the same complaint. So what they will do is, they will again send the e-fix to the another user. They keep on sending to users who are asking. After a month, what they will do is, they release something called APAR. What is APAR? Application patch. Which means, next time people should not raise complaint, rather put that error onto the fix central database. That will tell you, this is already fixed in APAR. APAR means, already fixed patches are there. You need not raise complaint. So you just go ahead and download and install it. This is called APAR. E-fix means you have to call and get APAR is already available. Is that fine? Okay. So some year back, it is like every 3 months, they collect all these APARs and create service pack. Service pack or SP. So that is called SP, service pack. Every 3 months. Now it is 6 months. Every 6 months, what they do, they collect all the APARs and create service pack, and service pack is released. So that is this fixed pack number. Getting it? And every 6 months, they used to collect all the service pack and put technology level or maintenance level. TL. It is called TL or ML, maintenance level, or in older version, it is called maintenance level. New version, it is called technology level. Is that fine? So first e-fix, then it becomes APAR, then service pack and technology level are official releases where service pack and technology level are available for download if you have a proper license. If you have a proper license, you can download it and install it. Okay, what's the difference between service pack and TL? Group of APARs is service pack. Group of service pack is TL. Then what is the difference between service pack and TL? TL doesn't have just the software updates, it also comes up with support for new hardware. For example, IBM releases hardware, right? 2 months before they release some new hardware, after 2 months they release some more new hardware. Like the processor will get upgraded or motherboard will get changed. So that becomes a new model. When new model comes, for that new model, device driver is required. That device driver also comes along with the TL. You getting it? So this TL is not just a group of service pack, it also have support for your hardware. You getting it? Is it clear? Okay. So now we have TL0, SP0, which means this is a base AX operating system. Okay. Whenever you find something like this, 7.1.2.3, what is the meaning? AX 7.1, TL2, service pack 3. Yeah, if it is something like 7.1.1.7, AX 7.1, TL1, and SP7. Is that fine? So this is how you have to read the OS level command, and OS level hyphen S. Oh, it's not coming. Is there a loose connection? One sec. Let the projector be on. The lamp was, when it abruptly off, it takes some time to Just switch off. Don't switch off. No. Silence. Sorry, the projector is on.
Yeah.
Okay. So you see that OS level IPNS output, which will come on screen. The OS level IPNS will give you a detailed output of VRMF. Okay, I'll tell you how to read this. The 7100 is nothing but AX7.1. Okay. This 00 is nothing but your TL level. And this one is nothing but your service pack level, which is showing 0. I'll tell you why there are some issues is there which we need to fix. Okay, and you see this number. What is this? This is year week, which means year 2010, 37th week, when this patch got released. Okay, so YY is 2010. 37 means 37th week. In the 37th week of year 2010, this patch got released. Okay, instead of this number, it shows CSP. What is CSP? Close of service pack. Which means IBM have stopped creating service pack for this particular TL. So there's no more update coming up. Is that fine? So now we know what is emergency fix, APAR, TLs and SPs. We are getting further. I want you guys to have an ID created. I hope some of you would have created an ID for a fixed central site. Okay. So in interview, they will ask you from how, where will you download the patches? How will you install those patches? So we'll see how that's been. So their site is FixCentral, F-I-X-C-E-N-T-R-A-L. Search for FixCentral. FixCentral. You see the very first site, IBM FixCentral. Go to IBM FixCentral. You have created a username password, IBM ID?
Yes.
You already have. So everybody is supposed to create an IBM ID, without which you cannot call yourself an IBM engineer. Okay. So over here, you have an option to download. So you have to select this. You can select product. Product group. You can select. System P. Yeah, this is System P servers. Product AX. Version. These are the versions you have. Select AX7. Function. Okay. Whenever you find time, please download best practices, read it, implement it in your company. User management, how you do it. LVM management, how you do it. When should you patch? Everything is there in the best practices. At least before interview, you should go through this best practices. A very good document is there. We go for fixed packs. Fixed pack is nothing but service packs and TL. I'll tell you how. So now it is submitting an order and it will fetch the information from the IBM site and it will show you. To download, you need to have an IBM ID created. Okay. So first, let's see what the content of this output. So where will you download the patches, TL service packs? FixCentral. Don't forget this location, yeah? Okay. So we have some output. It will take some time to refresh. Let's wait. I'll show you one roadmap. When the TLs, when the SPs are being released and when it is going to get closed, we'll see that and we'll come back to this ATM number, and I want you to tell which is TLS, which is service pack, and when the service pack got released. Yeah, it's still loading. That's kind of graphics has roughly 34 results, so it will take some time. Yeah, I'll allow it to load it. It's much easier, like Windows, search in Microsoft TechNote, whatever, wherever you download the patches. You have to search and get the appropriate patches. Okay, let's take some time. Yeah. Here it is. Okay, you can see that some nodes are there, APAR version. Forget it for the timing. I'll take you to the last. You see the graph, roadmap? This red line is now you are here. Okay, before going for interview, you should make sure that which is the latest release TLS in this piece. Okay, so AX 7.1, TL1, TL2, TL3 is there. They are releasing appropriate service packs. You see this SP9, SP10. They say final AX pack, SP10. So there is no more TL1, SP11 is going to come. So you should not install AX 7.1, TL1. If you install, what will happen? There's no updates. For TL2, within short time, within a couple of months, SP7 will be released, and that's the last one. So you have to be keep up to date that when you are going to stop. What is the latest service pack released? TL3 SP5. Got it? Same goes with AX6.1. You're able to make it? So these are technology levels, and this is service pack. So technology level will go from TL1, TL2, TL3 up to TL12. You see AX6.1, 7, 8, 9 has come. It will go up to 10, 11, 12. Once 12 is reached, 6.1 will be removed, AX8.1 will come. Same way, service pack for each TL will go from SP1, SP2, SP3 up to SP12. Once SP12 is released, they say CSP. They go for the next TL. Okay? So when is service pack released? Once in every 6 months. When is the TL released? Once in a year. Yeah? Is that fine? Okay. So what is the latest AX7 TL? AX7 TL3 SP5. SP5. Before going for interview, make a note. Yeah, for AX6, TL9, SP5. Is that fine? Okay.
No support for AX5.
No, there's no support for AX5. 6 and 7 are the only currently supported. You can get support for 5 on extended support. You have to pay extra. Okay, so just don't look at the service pack, the left side name. Can you just by looking at the number, can you make it out with a service pack or TL? Yeah, how will you find out is the service pack or TL? How?
Last four digits.
So what is 7100?
7.1.
What is 03?
TL.
What is 05? If this number is not 00, it's 01, 02, 03. That means they are service pack. If it is 00, that is TL. I'll show you some TL. You see the TL? 00. Service pack 00 is technology level. Service pack is TL-01. Okay? And you see for every technology level service pack, there are compare report, fixed detail, install instructions, and all this stuff. Just download it and read through this document. At least one TL document and one SP document you have to download. That's one of the exercises for you. And then go through the document how to install. Is that fine? Okay. So when you are clicking a service pack, you get one more option here. You see this? What is that? When I'm clicking service pack, I'm getting a TL as well. So it is asking me, do you want TL also to be downloaded? TL is some 4 GB, service pack is 1 GB. You can just ignore it, only 1 GB will get downloaded. You say TL, then 5 GB will be downloaded. So technology level plus service packs will come in. Is that fine? Okay. So every SP is linked, crossed, closely linked with technology levels. Any issues? In IBM world, whenever an application, their compatibility list is with their AX 7.1, TL3, SP4. They'll say, I want this TL, this SP. Even though a new TL has come, new SP has come, they will not upgrade because their application or database is not supported. You're getting it? Yeah. Which one? The 00. Yeah. If this two digits are 00, that means that's a technology level. If it is not 00, it's a 01, 02, 03, kind of 06, they are service pack. Yeah, is that fine?
Service pack is not available.
No, you have an option to download only service pack or with the technology level. If by default it is not checked, you can check it. Size of technology level is roughly 3GB, 4GB. Service pack is 600 MB to 1GB. So depends on your requirement, you download the respective TLs and SP. If you already have TL3 installed, you need not download TL3. You have to just download the SP. If you have not installed TL3, it is TL00. You have to download TL3 and also SP. That's fine.
Any version of service pack?
No. Any version of service pack you can install, but your application should support. Yeah?
Suppose I have TL2 service pack 1.
Cannot be used for TL3 SP. TL2 SP1 and TL3 SP1 are two different service packs.
But can I install TL2 service pack 5 after service pack 1?
Yeah, you can do it. But usually it is advised to go step by step. Service pack 1, service pack 2, service pack 3, like kind of. But you can go with that SP5. Normally we do like that. When you do SP5, it will not throw SP5. See? It is supposed to show SP1. Not showing 1. Because there is some issue. Now we have to find that issue and fix it. This is one of the troubleshooting we do. Which is much easier than installing 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah? Only fix only what is broken. Yeah, so after installing a package, we can run command like lpp check -v. It's no showing no output, which means your packages are clean. Okay, inst fix -i, this is an interview question. They'll ask, how will you check inconsistent packages, inconsistent TL levels? Okay, pipe grep -i ml. You see all file sets are installed. If it shows not all file sets, that means that there is some issue. Okay, if there's an issue, I'll tell you how to fix. Okay, how to check, this is for TL, right? ML means technology level, maintenance level. How to check for service pack? inst fix -i, pipe grep -i, SP. So it says all file sets were found. Since all files are available, nothing is going wrong. Okay, so if you want to check OS level -rl and you say this number, OS level -rl Okay, this is a base, no? That's why it's not showing. If it is 7.1 TL1, TL2, you will get some messages saying that these packages are not matching the package level. Let's say VRMF, right? Version release maintenance fix pack, which is supposed to be 7.1.3.1, but it is having only 7.1.2.1. So what we have to do? We have to download those 7.1.3.1 package, only those package, and install it. Is that fine? Yeah, okay. How to install, we'll see. So instfix -i is one of the command you need to know. OS level -rl and OS level -sl. RL for checking the technology level packages, SL for checking the service level packages. Is that fine? Is this a troubleshooting point you need to know? So if they say, the question may be something like this. You installed TL3, but it is still showing TL2. What is the issue? So some packages are in downgraded file sets. So how will you check? Instfix -i, pipe grep -i ml. I'll see not all file sets lines, and I'll try to do OS level -rl, and I will try to find which are the file sets, download them and fix it. Is that fine?
OS level -rl
for TL packages missing. TL. SL for service level packages. Service pack packages.
And for that is for
that's for checking whether all the file sets are consistently installed. Yeah, that is there in the exercise. Once you upgrade the TL, you'll be doing this activity. So whoever been tasked with TL upgrade, we'll see whether he's doing it. Okay, now it's installing packages. Okay, so we have some packages. We'll just see under it's been downloaded under CD temp. You see some packages. Some are RPM packages, right? PNC, bash. Okay, I type bash. Bash not found. Okay, so I don't have bash here. So there are some commands. We'll see commands later. We'll go with smitty and do the install and other stuff. So what I am doing is smit to install software. Where I have to go? Install. Install a software. Now it is asking where is the software kept. Where did I keep the software? /tmp. So only two things are mandatory. One is input, which is already given, temp. Software, whatever I want to install, I can select. Okay, let me just select. Escape code. Is reading the temp directory and finding, oh, we have bash RPM. Yeah, I'm pressing escape 7 to select. See the arrow key? You want to install sudo? Or we'll install only bash now? Enter. Okay, only bash is going to get installed. If I hit enter, it's going to run the bash. But before getting in, I'm going to say, what is preview? What is preview? Preview means, yeah, it will just check whether all the prerequisites for installing this bash program, this much space on OPT should be there. You are root user. It will check all the prerequisites. It will not install. So this will give you some idea that if something is missing beforehand. Okay. Usually it is no. If you want, you can say it yes. Okay. Say it yes. Okay. There's something called commit, reject, accept. What is commit? Not accept. Commit, applied, reject. What is commit? Yeah. There are three states. Commit, applied, reject. Okay. Let's see about commit and applied. Okay. Let me just take Windows as an example. You already have MS Office 2000 installed on your machine. Now, you have to install MS Office 2003. If you run in commit mode, what will happen? Huh? Yeah, it will remove this and it will only install MS Office 2003. Old version will go off and only new version would be there. You cannot go back to the original state. If you are running in applied mode, what will happen? Both will be there. MS Office 2000 also will be there. 2003 also will be there. But whenever you click Word, 2003 only will get opened. Okay. So you always run any new programs in applied mode. Whenever there's an issue, you can say reject. When you say reject, what will happen? This will go. It will go back to its original state. When I say commit, after 6 months, I find that 2003 is okay. I don't want 2000. You can say commit, this will go off. But till the time, two MS Office would be there. This MS Office is 1000 MB, we'll have 2000 MB wasted. But the advantage is, something goes wrong, you can revert back to its original state by just rejecting. If you are happy after 6 months, commit it. Now we know what is commit, applied, reject. Commit means keep only one copy. Old version will be removed. Applied means keep both, latest will be the current one. Reject means reject the current applied one, go back to its original. Is that fine? So you want to commit update. And there is one more. Accept new license agreement, you have to say yes. I'm going to hit enter. You know that it is in preview only. is not going to get installed. You can either run this command, gen install command, manually, instead of Smith, but it's always better to run. It says okay. When you say okay, you can see that packages are good to go. It's not installed, so what are you going to do? Previous no. Hit enter. Now it will install. Last time it did not install. You can see that it is getting installed. You see? Please wait. Last time it was only validating. This time it is getting installed. Before when I type bash, it said bash not found. Now when I type bash, it will get. Is that software installation stuff? Smitty, install, give the path, preview or commit, enter. In Windows, you have to click next, next. You have to search for next. One time next would be here, the other time next would be in another place. Here, only one time, hit enter, it will install the package. All activities fully automated. Yeah? Let's see. Let's wait for the command to succeed. The running should become okay. Package installation is very easy. Package update is also very easy. You have to install software, you have to go for update software and give the latest version. That's it. But when it comes to TL upgrade, the steps are different. Oh, good. Yeah, good. It says okay, which means the program got installed. Now you type bash, it's working.
The bash package.
Bash package. It's a shell. Now you say mku. See, autocomplete.
Okay.
Doing all mk commands. I type mkw. D. This is called command autocomplete. I want to edit, I can even edit. You see that? Yeah, command line history. You can see this. See this? This is where okay it is going. Yeah, this is called command line history, command editing, and autocomplete. Bash as well. Installation is fine. Okay. So TL upgrade is one of the important part. So they will ask you, how will you upgrade TL in the interview? What would be your answer? It's almost the same procedure, I'm telling you. Download the TL from Fix Central. Keep it in one directory. Smitty install. Give the path of the directory. It will do the installation. But TL upgrade has something specific you have to answer. Interviewer will be looking for these details. Okay? Number one, TL and a service pack are very closely linked with applications. So we have to always go with change management process to check whether this TL and service pack are agreed by your application team and database team. This is the first thing you have to answer. But the second one is, TL is always run in commit mode. You know, apply and commit, right? TL can only run in commit mode. What is the commit mode then? You install the TL, you cannot go back to your original state. So the problem is, something goes bad, your OS is crashed. Again, you have to install OS and get to that level. So TL is always running. This is a very important point you have to say in your interview. TL installation is always run in commit mode so that we should always take alt disk install or alt disk update. What is alt disk? We clone another hard disk with the same OS image, update the second image, see that is working. If that is not working, revert back to its original state. So that is a very important point. We'll see that on the expert class, how to take all disk install. Okay. So what is the important point second? TLs are always run on commit mode. So TL has to be installed just in all disk install method. Alt disk. Alt disk means taking a backup on another hard disk. And update the hard disk with the new TL, check it is working, then you revert back. That's called alt disk install. Third step is, before applying TL, you have to commit all applied patches. You know what is commit all applied patches? There are many other software installations have been done all these days. They are in applied mode. Everything has to be committed.
Commit
all applied patches. Very important. Fourth important point they are looking for is remove all interim fixes. Emergency fix we put right. Remove all the emergency fixes, interim fixes. Yeah, that's the fourth point. Fifth point is go with the TL update. You know how to do the TL update? Smitty install, give the path and do the TL in commit mode. After finishing, restart the machine. Check your TL is working fine. If okay, leave it. If it is not okay, boot through the alt disk. So TL update is more like software installation, but these five steps are very important. You have to say why it is doing so and you have to say the answer. So
you have to run it on
alt disk. Yeah. So you have to say why. TL is always run on commit mode, so there's no backup. So we have to always do alt disk install.
Alt disk means like suppose TL3 we are going to install.
Yeah.
We have to install it on some other drive.
You have another free drive. You will say alt disk install. First, your OS disk will get copied to that disk. And on that disk, you install the TL. So your current running application will be running on your original disk with TL0. The only this disk get TL3 updated. Restart the machine with TL3. See your application is working fine. If it is not working, change the boot order to the old machine, old drive. If it is working, leave it. If it is not working, then only you have to change it.
Another point.
Remove interim fixes. Commit all applied patches. So these three are very important points. Please make sure that you speak this on your interview. There are some sites like torontoax.com which has the step-by-step procedure of it. AX for admins is a very good blogspot. IBM Developer Works is a very good blogspot. Go and see TL update procedure and then go for interview. It's a sure shot interview question. How will you update TL? These 4-5 points have been keenly looked at. Only the person who have done TL update can say an answer. We already have a TL download and kept here. You can install that. So far, 4 batches crossed. Nobody have done it. And you are the 5th batch. Probably if you do it, better. Somebody own it. Install the TL. Okay, the steps are there in Toronto X and also on the document, the lab section that I'm going to share. You'll get those. So, you know how to do TL update? You're ready for the interview? They ask you what is TL update, you can answer. Yeah, these 5 points you should not forget. Yeah? This is it. It's under VAR, VAO, VM library. Yeah, I'll show you. Telnet 192.168.2.200 admin cd var vao vm library.
Yes,
this is a TL directory. Packages are here.
Where
do
you have to install?
On one of your helper. Whichever helper you have, Raj helper, Nim helper, whatever helper you have created, on that helper. Now it is showing AX 7.1.0.0. This after install it will become 7.1.3.4.
So we have to check the service pack. Oh,
yeah.
We have to check the mode, commit mode or apply mode.
Correct.
So move it to commit mode. Then.
Yeah, you follow the procedure. Yeah, since your OS is brand new, you will not find any update patches. But go ahead with the procedure as described. Yeah? Any questions on TL update? I want you to create an IBM fixed central ID, mandatory. And then go ahead and see this patches, compare report, fixed details, browse through this. If you're not good enough in fixed central, you cannot say you are an AX engineer. Okay? And you should be able to say how to check OS level, how to do instafix. Is that fine? Any doubts on this? Any questions, concerns on software installation? So there are many options available. You can just see here. Smith, software installation maintenance. You have many options here, right? Software maintenance. This is the regular thing that you do. You can see commit, apply software, reject, remove software, rename image repository. So there are many options are there. Usually we do the first few things. Commit, reject, remove, everything is there. So you need to know only English, not AX. Only four letter words, Smith, SMIT, you're an AX engineer. No, I'm not giving you a wrong direction. I'm saying the fact. Even I have 15 year experience, I'm supposed to run only Smith. The reason is, something goes bad, IBM will give free support. You do write command, something breaks, you are supposed to pay penalty to IBM. IBM will charge you. So your manager, everyone will always recommend using. It's an important interview question. Nowadays it's become an icebreaker question. Mm-hmm. Technically, they'll ask, okay, it seems to be you're a patch management guy, your resume shows you are updated TL and all this stuff. Tell me, how will you update TL? Our very first question. May happen. Don't fear. Those 5 points are very important. You should not forget. Change management, all disk install, remove interim fixes, update, commit mode, then install the TL. Yeah. So these are some of the important things that you need to know. Yeah, and the install, update, remove, everything is there through the stuff.
What will happen if you don't do this stuff?
It will get installed, but it will get corrupted. Yeah. Unnecessarily, you are if you don't commit your applied patches, it's going to shoot up space. Both packages will be there and it will conflict. Whenever you're doing TL update, every patch should be committed. Yeah. You have a lab, you can try without committing, without doing this. You can crash your LPAP, no worries. Yeah. No, try it. No, we can do it only here. Do it on customer environment is not supposed to be. Don't ever try a single command which you are not aware on a customer environment, production. On the lab is fine. Yeah, make sure. Some environments, lab server is a production server. In R&D and all, lab servers are called production servers. So be careful. Don't just go with the name. You should have a proper KT receipt for this. Yeah. So any questions on software installation maintenance? The guys on webinars? So any questions? So everybody have to create an IBM Fix Central ID. That's what I want to say. Okay. So just we'll ask for IBM ID. Create an IBM ID. So long we kept, so the session got out. Create an IBM ID, IBM sign in, register, and then you'll be able to download patches and all this stuff. Is that fine? Yeah. So who is going to do the TL update procedure? At least in this patch. Huh? You'll wait? Wait. Fine, so I think we ran over lunchtime. Yeah. So too much of knowledge is also will kill the rat. Yeah. So what we'll do is we'll stop for a day. We'll see the remaining portions tomorrow or sometime later. Yeah. I'll tell you about my tomorrow's plan. Any other questions? Any questions? Just stop.